with a warm round of applause, please welcome Justin Zabor as he attempts to put the fun back in funerals. Justin Zabor.
Ladies and gentlemen, how do you feel about undertakers? You know, Mr. Morbid, Dr. Death, Rigor Mortis. I am a third generation undertaker, or 3 feet under, instead of the usual six, as we like to call it. Now, third generation means that my grandfather and my father before me were undertakers as well. So I'm not only involved, I guess you could say I'm pretty much buried in the family business. Now imagine that you had grown up around death your entire life, just like me, and that to you, death was simply a normal part of your day, such as driving to work or texting a friend. Of course, if you really do text while driving, you might be coming to see me sooner than you think. Now, people have different names for what it is I do. They call me undertaker, funeral director, mortician, funeral service professional, the guy with the cold, limp handshake. But the one I like the best, and the one I use to describe myself, is funeral service professional. I like this term because of the emphasis on the word service. Because service is not only what I do, it is who I am. I am a professional who serves. And you too are professionals who serve, every single one of you. So I guess it really doesn't matter whether you're a funeral service professional, a professional speaker, or an association executive, or a meeting planner. You are all professionals who serve. I guess the only difference is that your members or customers might end up buried in paperwork, and mine, well, you know. Now imagine that you do what I do. I'm a funeral director and an expert who speaks professionally about service through my program, Customer Service to Die For. 5 service secrets from the funeral profession. As a matter of fact, secret number 1 is that small acts of service can make a big difference. More on that later. But yes, I am an expert in customer service. And do you know how I know that I'm an expert? Because, ladies and gentlemen, I have a perfect customer service record. That's right. I've never had a client complain, ever. Now, some were cold and indifferent, but nobody ever complained. Now, many of you might be thinking, Justin, your job is a real downer. But the truth is, it's really not. It can be incredibly fulfilling to help a family out on one of the worst days of their lives. Furthermore, there is humor in the funeral business, believe it or not, just like there is in your business. You just have to dig a little deeper for it. For example, one of the worst things that can happen is for a family to come into the funeral home and for them to think that Grandpa always looked like Harrison Ford, but when they come into the funeral home, he looks like Rodney Dangerfield. I mean, that's never a good thing. So we always ask for a picture, so we see how that person wore their hair and their makeup. Maybe they wore glasses. But again, we're always a little apprehensive when that family comes in to the funeral home for the first time. We do the very best we can to try to make them look like themselves when they were alive, but sometimes we can't because, well, they're not alive. So this one particular day, this son was coming into the parlor to view his deceased mother for the first time. And again, I let him have a few moments alone, but after he came out of the parlor, I approached him a little apprehensively, and I said to him, "So, John, does your mom look okay?" And John replied, he said, "Justin, if my mom would have known that she'd look this good dead, she would have kicked the bucket 10 years ago." So yes, as you can see, there is humor in the funeral business, just like there is in all of your businesses. And as I said before, sometimes it really is those small acts of service that can make the biggest difference. Now, I realize that many of you here in this room today have lost loved ones. And I'm sorry about that. Honestly, I really am. But please don't mistake my humor for insensitivity. I think you'll find that funeral directors are some of the most sensitive, compassionate, and empathetic people you'll ever meet, myself included. But here's why I have the right to talk to you today about service. Because the truth is, even though I may never have lost anybody in my immediate family, I have served hundreds and hundreds of individuals and families who have. And this service, this undertaking, if you will, has taught me not only what it takes to be successful in this business of death, but even more importantly, it has taught me what living a life of service is all about. Let me say that a different way. The business of death has taught me more about life. And when you understand what's truly important in life, you understand how to serve others more effectively. Providing customer service to die for, ladies and gentlemen, doesn't mean that you have to kill yourself in the process. Although I'm sure all of us can identify clients that made us consider it, right? No. Many times it can mean quite the opposite. Sometimes it really is those small acts of service that can have the greatest impact. This became very apparent to me a few years ago when I was staying late at the cemetery to oversee a grave being filled in after a funeral service. Now, the family had already left the graveside, but I noticed a middle-aged woman hovering over another grave about 30 yards away. Now, this woman had not been a part of the funeral service we had just completed, and I noticed that she was looking over at me as if she knew me. Now, I know I'm striking, and I'm used to women of all ages looking at me. No, not really, just kidding. But this seemed different. So after a few moments, I decided to approach her, and I realized as I got closer, it was probably my male ego talking. She wasn't looking at me, but she was looking at a headstone. So as I approached, I glanced at the dates on the stone, and just kind of to break the ice, I said, "He died too young." And she said, "Yes, he did. He was my son." Whew, wasn't ready for that. And I listened to her tell a few stories about her son, but for the most part, I said nothing. I just listened. You know, sometimes all we need to do is be present. But after a few moments, she stopped talking. She looked me directly in the eyes. I'll never forget this. And she said, "May I give you a hug?" I was really feeling like I needed a hug from my son today. So he gave one to me, I guess, in the only way that he could, through you. Thank you for listening to me today. You made my day. And as I left the cemetery that day, I thought to myself, how often in our personal or our professional lives do we get the chance to make someone's day? Well, you all know the answer. Of course, it's every single day. Every single day we do our jobs to the best of our ability. Every time we give 110%, we're giving ourselves a chance to make someone's day. True service means recognizing that opportunity and taking action on it. And that is what I mean, ladies and gentlemen, by providing customer service to die for.